So what's going on, guys? It's JM, it's Speedboxing. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel before you click on 20 of my videos. Also, comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So, Unified Heavyweight Champion of the World, Anthony Joshua, has been granted an exemption by the IBF. The IBF have ruled in favour of Anthony Joshua, and that doesn't mean he will be stripped of his IBF world title if he faces Vladimir Klitschko next in a rematch. The IBF have allowed him to continue to carry the IBF title if he faces Vladimir Klitschko next, but he must face Vladimir Klitschko by December the 2nd of this year. And this is very interesting. A lot of people are saying this is unfair by the IBF to let Anthony Joshua get a pass like this, because the IBF have been strict in the past with opponents, like when Tyson Fury didn't fight his mandatory Glasskov because he had a rematch clause with Vladimir Klitschko. They stripped him straight away. But the thing is, Eddie Hearn and his team played it smart here. They've came along and they put this exemption in before Cali Sauland, who is a promoter of Kubrat Pulev, received a letter about the mandatory spot and when to negotiate a fight between Kubrat Pulev and Anthony Joshua. Eddie Hearn had already had this planned. So this is good business by Eddie Hearn. This is good strategy by Eddie Hearn to do this. But I can see why people think this is unfair, because Julius Ndongo is the IBF light welterweight champion, and he holds the WBA and IBO titles, just like Anthony Joshua in the light welterweight divisions. And he's looking to face WBC, WBO and Ring Magazine champion Terence Crawford in an undisputed title fight. But the IBF are saying that they are going to strip him if he takes the fight with Terence Crawford, so that means that fight won't be for the undisputed light welterweight title. So yeah, I can understand why people are saying this is unfair, because Anthony Joshua has a lot of money behind him, he's a very popular fighter. But at the end of the day, Eddie Hearn has strategized this. He has thought about this before it's even happened, like before Kubrat Pulev and his team could negotiate a fight and call purse bids. Because if Kubrat Pulev and his team would have received this letter and called purse bids, and Eddie Hearn didn't put this exemption in, then he would have had to fight Kubrat Pulev no matter what, Anthony Joshua, or he would have been stripped of his IBF title. But because Eddie Hearn has put in this exemption before Sauland and Pulev have got this letter, then they have managed to sort the situation out, and Anthony Joshua can still be the IBF champion going into a fight with Vladimir Klitschko. But that fight must happen before December the 2nd of this year. Eddie Hearn is saying he's looking for that fight for November of this year, so I think that fight will happen by then. We're just going to have to wait now what Vladimir Klitschko is going to do, if he's going to accept the rematch, if he's going to exercise his rematch clause. Eddie Hearn thinks that Vladimir Klitschko and his team are going to say yes to the rematch, and we're going to have this rematch by November of this year. And a lot of people are saying they don't want to see the rematch. They think Anthony Joshua won the fight and that Anthony Joshua should move on. But at the end of the day, it was a very competitive fight until Anthony Joshua managed to get his second wind and rally on late on the fight. And it was a fantastic fight, and I wouldn't mind seeing it again. Like, if it has to happen again, then it's not the worst thing in the world at the end of the day, because it was a fantastic fight the first time around. Not like it was a dual fight like the Vladimir Klitschko Tyson Fury fight. Yeah, Tyson Fury dominated Vladimir Klitschko and beat him on points, but it was a very dual fight, very low volume of punches and stuff like that. So I'd rather see an Anthony Joshua Vladimir Klitschko rematch than when we nearly had to see a Tyson Fury Vladimir Klitschko rematch. I think the fight was sold very well again. So yeah, this is very interesting. What do you guys think of this? Do you think this is unfair for the IBF to do this for Anthony Joshua but not for other people? Just comment below in the comment section. It's JM and Speedboxing.